What's good, everybody? We here back with the Emphatic Truth. We started this part two section, Tools of Liberation, and this pretty much is going to be giving us an idea of what steps we need to take in 2016 to get ourselves right inside the mind and ultimately in our family structure, community structure, and neighborhoods. One of the biggest things that we're going to be talking about here today is an introduction, step-by-step tool of what got us interested. I'm here with my good friend Abdul Muhammad, who you'll be meeting in just a few seconds, but just want to give you a little background on how I got involved and what interests me in this particular topic of self-education and reading. So basically, this past fall, actually, I was taking a class called The Culture of Africa, and that was sort of a foreign language substitute offered at my university. And it was pretty much something I really had no idea that it was even offered, and I really had no real idea of African culture or really identified myself as being a part of African descendants. And that's pretty much sad to say, but it was true once I really got into class and really learning about some of the things my ancestors was able to go through and build and prosper and remain in this unique society. And having not learned any of that, I was pretty much taken back. And we had some white people in the class, and it was pretty much an all-white class besides two or three black people. And we was oftentimes hear comments like, I'm glad I'm not in that situation. I'm glad, you know, I don't live over there, speaking of Africa. And it pretty much brought that into reality, that this same point of view has led us into the destruction that we are ultimately seeing amongst ourselves and in foreign places. So what this podcast is really going to be generating is going to be generating a slew of ideas of what you can do to sort of start your self-education process off with. And what I would encourage you to just first start with is yourself, is readily identifying with yourself, whatever your heritage is all going to be brought back on what do you know about your history? How can you pinpoint where your ancestors go back? Where's your lineage? And for African Americans or black people, we really don't have that pinpoint history, because for a long time, it hasn't been shared with us. So we, when we see each other, we don't look at each other as a necessarily a high person or someone we should be even looking up to in society. And that's what we're, you know, here to change. And through that class and learning about the culture of Africa, the great empires, and how some of the greatest structures were built in Africa, which is the motherland, and how that was so much taken away from them in so many different ways through government systems and neocolonial powers and bastardizations of colonies and tribes, it really led us to the destruction of not only a race of the black person, but the continent as a whole of Africa. And now we see us in a society is oftentimes not even wanting to identify with Africa, as we associate that with something that is bad. So this podcast will pretty much open up those insights and open up those conversations where we can gain more knowledge and information and actually identify ourselves with being that true African that we should want to be. And instead of relying on someone else to give us that information, we're going to, you know, speak on it ourselves and engage in dialogue and monologue and pretty much open those doors so we can start talking and actually doing something besides talking about it, as we oftentimes do or see in the black community. And my good friend Abdul Muhammad, he can introduce himself. We came down here from Morgan State, and he can go ahead. Keep going, Abdul.
What's up, everybody? This is Abdul Muhammad. Blog is The Pharaoh's Journey, here to enlighten, open up the truth. First of all, this is 2016, and one of the biggest goals we need to do in the community is educate yourself as much as possible. Is it getting a degree, self-educating yourself? Which one is for you? Do that, as well as opening up your own business. what do you want to pass on to the person that's coming up after you? You have to leave a legacy. So opening businesses so that you have something you stand by, you know? You want ownership. But we've been impressed so much to think that we need to go to the corporate plantation. No, we don't. We can own our own business. It might be hard, but life is hard. Nobody's going to feel sorry for you in this world, man.
Trust.
You just got to keep it moving. And we see what's going on in the community. Nobody's going to feel sorry for you, so you must make your situation better. If anybody's giving you an idea that, you say, you're broke, you're poor, it doesn't matter. That's their idea. Whatever your self-image is about yourself, you keep it. Because there's one thing about the subconscious mind. Whatever you tell the subconscious mind, that's what it'll attract. And everything I'm speaking from the heart, soul, and mind. So you understand where I'm coming from. This is real rap. The Pharaoh's Journey. The emphatic truth. My bad, made a mistake, but we still on it.
No, you good, bro. And that's what it's really about. It's really about adapting in whatever way you know how and can identify with. If you can identify with African culture or just by reading a book or looking at a lecture, as I did, then that's how you can begin to learn your information. When I first started reading some of the books, I hated reading. I never even read books up until I used to skim through a lot of books, and now I have like iBooks filled with different books that I begin to read. And some of the biggest influential people that I sort of looked up to or started to mirror styles or philosophies or books or read their books was one of Dr. Yosef Ben Yochanan.
He's a powerful man.
Yeah, it really is. And Dr. John Henry Clark, Dr. Chancellor Williams, who wrote The Destruction of the Black Civilization, and so many other people who, Dr. Umar Johnson, who is more of a contemporary type of guy who really relates to the our generation, if you will, and he really talks to what we can be doing in our communities and what we really should be doing, not what we could be doing. It's more so what we should be doing. And what I like about him is his versatile ability to talk about the medical side of a lot of the things that we deal with in the Black community, and also the perception coming from that philosophy of being a psychologist and dealing with kids. So it's just so many different people you can talk to and really get to know about their works and begin to learn this information. But it really comes from the idea that you have to want to learn it. And like Abdul was saying, if you're gonna, I guess, be beat around the bush with the information or take some information and then question it and not really do your research or look at the wrong person, look up to the wrong person, that can really influence how you perceive this information. Because it's one thing to be conscious
right.
and aware of what's going on, and then it's another thing to be actively and going out to pursue and, right. and wanting to change what's going on. So that starts and then it starts with the immediate people around you. So that's excluding a lot of the things that we're doing, a lot of the foods that we even
right.
Eat. So it doesn't have to get that deep, but it really goes to the extent that everything that around us is we're being affected by. And
right.
if we're not hip to it, it's like you just walking around in a cloud of smoke. And mm-hmm. then when you get out that smoke, it's just like, yeah, where the heck I'm at? So we just here to, you know, to bring you some of our perspectives and information on you know, what we think.
Yeah, and definitely, first thing I gotta say is religion, number one in the Black community. First of all, I'm gonna tell you like this, point blank. Jesus is not coming back to save nobody's life. As well as that, your oppressor gave you all of these religion to dumb you down. Back then, Christianity and religion was used to oppress Black people. So think about it, we're still using it today time. A lot of things have been outdated and we need to wake up. And we need to see the truth. We are gods. We have God within us. We have divine powers. You feel me?
Yeah.
You don't just pray when something bad happens. Pray every single day. Don't just post stuff when something... Pray every single day. You feel me? We are divine beings having a spiritual feeling in this universe right now. So just enjoy it. You feel me? These are religions that are man-made. You can't tell somebody how to worship God because they all have their different relationship with it. Back to what I said, like you were saying with Umar Johnson, it is correct, man. You got to understand what is going on. You have to read. And we have this some type of stereotype, this intellectual stereotype about people who read. You're trying to act a certain way. It's good to read. It's good to get knowledge.
Right, right. And I thought that for a long time. Like, I thought people who read was just reading some corny stuff on this one kid in my middle school used to read the dictionary and, like, pick his boogers for real. And I used to clown him, but then when I really got to know him, he was cool, and Bull ended up going to I think, Princeton or Harvard. So he really dedicated himself to, like,
studies.
To his studies and really didn't take that for a joke, even though everybody else was. And having, you know, gone to college and graduated college and realized that it's a lot of other stuff that I did not learn while I was in school, it really has, you know, made me
yearn. Brought that up.
Yeah, it made me yearn for the knowledge that I was missing. So, I, like,
thank
this
you.
this was like a sort of like a self-education type of a thing that we, you know, we sort of got involved in and with. And, like, Abdul can tell you, it wasn't something that was easy. So you can quickly speak on how you got involved and what led you to.
I definitely got involved in it by the people that I was around. You know, I'm in a fraternity, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, and, you know, I have a lot of brothers, you know, that helped me and guide me through my path, and I helped them as well. And, you know, we just see what's going on in the community, and we always make a difference. You know, our fraternity is known for that as well. And just seeing that, you know, I just realized, like, even going to college is great, but there's a lot of stuff that you need to learn sometimes. Going to entrepreneurship class sometime, learn how to own your own business is great. Think about it like this. When you in a corporation, you have one boss, right? When you're entrepreneur, you might have 15 clients. You still have a boss, but you have more flexibility. You feel me? You want to live on your own terms. And they don't teach us economics and economics the way we need to learn it. But you have to read. There's books out there. You got to really push yourself. Smoking and drinking, doing all the time is going to waste your time. You feel me? Right. It's not cool if you're 35 still asking your mom for money. And you've seen what the music industry have done. They've turned this, getting us to kill each other, drinking lean.
Right, they make a mockery
just
out
peep
of it,
what's
really.
Going on.
They really
just
do.
Just peep what's going on. Really peep what's going on. Spread positivity, man. Shout outs to every conscious people out there, man. Shout out to Sad Nutter. Shout out to Brother Polite, Shaka Most, all the conscious brothers out there in New York and just everywhere, LA, everywhere, man. Bless up, man. Hotep.
Yeah, and Thanks, Abdul, for even being a part of this. We just sort of just came up with this simple idea real quick just to give you guys an insight of what's to come and really how we got ourselves involved and interested in such a good movement that our generation is bound to be a part of, and more young folks. College and not in college is really becoming aware of the issues that we have to face when we get out of school or while we're in school. And like I was saying about why I got involved initially, it was initially because I did not know a lot of my history, and I did not know what, you know, Black history really meant. I thought history really began, you know, when we got here as slaves, and because mostly, more often than not, no one has told us any different. And to learn about dynastic periods of time and Greek people who lived, you know, for thousands of years before there was even an idea of enslavement of Blacks, it really hit home and made me want to be aware so I can actually tell somebody who I walk around and see with no hope that, you know, you are a king amongst other people and pharaohs and there are queens, you know,
kings and queens.
Queens that should be upholding themselves and
to
should
a
be
high standard.
Should be pretty much looking into themselves
high
for that
standard.
For that beauty and not relying on anyone. And us as kings in society have to really uphold that honor and not just walk around, you know, messing around and thinking our idea is always the right thing, and being stubborn and having that pride factor that hinders our growth. So it's all about growing and pretty much identifying what we come to do for our people and what we can do in our own communities. But like we both were saying, it really starts with ourselves and what we can make certain is our development. And once we make certain of that development, we can, you know, expand to other communities, and people will gain, you know, that trust and leadership and sense that leadership from you. And you don't want to lead a type of person, or you don't want a type of leader who really don't have their self together to begin with. And for a long time, I feel like that's what we've been under in here in the U.S. And what's to come for our generation is pretty much good things, but it's going to depend on us and our knowledge that we seek.
Most definitely, man. I'm just glad that we have a chance. We have a voice to make a difference. I was actually just reading. There's a 17-year-old guy. He's a CEO of a corporation that has 150 contractors, and he's in the business worth $3.5 billion. There's also a 12-year-old African-American kid who started a bow tie business with five of his friends, and now it's over like 12 million. So anything is happening. That's why I'm saying entrepreneurship is key. It's 2016.
Right.
We need to start our own businesses.
If you're still spending money like on some of the things like we see on TV just because someone else has it, and you know for sure you can't afford it, you probably should stop. Because like it's called stunting.
You're playing yourself.
And if you can't stunt to the fullest, then why are you even stunting at all? If anything, you should be investing your money instead of in belts and shoes.
Seminars,
that you don't wear. Like,
books,
it's about
seminars,
education.
Research.
Like,
it's about the education. Knowledge is the best thing in this world. Trust me. It's about your education. Seminars, book, everything, mentors, anything you can get a hold of. What do you think people who are more successful in the world, they get more mentors in the world? You want to always elevate yourself. Always reinvent yourself.
Right.
Never stay the same. You should always keep it going. Always keep it focused. We have one
goal. I think we got it so confused that we see people on TV and think they just got there overnight.
Yeah.
And we don't make the connection that the work and the time and the effort that is put into that. Granted, some people, you know, get grandfathered in, but at any rate, it takes an amount of work and effort.
Persistence and discipline.
Exactly. So if we're going to move the right way, like I've been hashtagging this slogan, 2K16 ready. Like if you're ready to really make a movement and a statement for not only our generation and yourself, but for the rest of the world, we have to, you know, really start to look at ourselves differently and uphold ourselves in a different standard. But you got anything left to say, brother?
Yeah, the only thing I gotta say is just stay up, man. Entrepreneurship is key, and we just gotta keep on going. Focus, man. Stay focused. It will be hard, but keep on going.